Welcome to a new video, guys. Today I will show you a new Paladin deck. It's a combo one-turn kill deck made by the Tard Hunter. As you can see, we are playing Leroy Jenkins, Faceless Manipulator and two Blessing of the Might. That will hit the opponent heavily in one turn. If we can decrease its mana cost with the Emperor. We are going against the Warrior, which is one of the worst matchups, because he can armor up, so we need Alexstrasza to decrease his health. As you can see in the decklist on the right, the rest of the deck mostly contains cards that will help you survive the early and mid game, so that you can put out your combo in the end game. As long as he's just armoring up, we don't need to play much cards here. No need to play a Doomsayer and prevent his next turn. He most likely will. Oh, he's playing his own Doomsayer. It's not bad for us. We can also just put out the Kodo. Yeah, let's do it this way. Put out a Kodo. So we have a better board. He can obviously kill the Sylvan Recruits with a Ravaging Ghoul or a Whirlwind. A slam, so he's attacking with the axe. And another Doomsayer. If we want, we can kill the Doomsayer, of course, if we play quality. But I don't think that it's necessary at the moment. We can also play the Keeper of Alderman onto the Doomsayer. But again, that might be a waste of resources here. So let's just hit 3 to the face. Then he's down at 24. We have 9 cards, so it's not a problem if we draw another one. Playing a Jessica. And I will put out an Aldor Peacekeeper. Follow the rule. We can also put out a Doomsayer as well if we like here. So we won't play anything next turn. And then we can, for example, play Lay on Hands to draw more cards and get to our combo faster. But I will wait for now. We can also easily play the Wild Pyromancer Equality and clear the board if it gets too crowded, and afterwards play the Doomsayer. Okay, he's killing the Elder Peacekeeper with a bash. There's a Blood of Brave. Let's put out the first Doomsayer. And we can play Silver and Recruit. Doesn't matter if he's attacking him and has a 5-5, we can still clear the board. And if he has a Ghoul, he can of course easily kill the Doomsayer. So we will play the Wild Pyromancer and Equality next turn. And also put out the Doomsayer here, like I explained earlier. And dropping the Tyrion now. At the moment he has too much health, so we can't kill him if we draw the combo. And we need Alexstrasza to reduce the life here. Just because effect that he's getting 4 armor per turn is pretty bad for us. So he's sinking. And playing a Blood Half and armoring up, okay. It's not a problem. Don't test me, child. He has most likely a brawl in hand. So it might be bad if we play the Ragnaros. But on the other hand, we can reduce his armor. If we play the Ragnaros, we won't activate the hero power. So we have 2 strong minions. And this is of course crap if we get this one out of the brawl. So let's make the Ragnaros. If we are losing the Tyrion, we of course get the weapon via the brawl. So that wouldn't be the worst outcome. Best outcome is of course if we have the Ragnaros on the board. He's armoring up. And a shield slam. A bash, man to execute. So no Harrison Jones. We have 8 cards at the moment at hand. So if we play the Lay on Hands, we need to play a card that has 2 mana or less. But we can play the Forbidden Healing, of course. So we will draw 3 cards. Then let's drop the Forbidden Healing, yeah? That belongs in a museum. There is the Harrison Jones.
Do you have the artifact?
And an Elise. Let's kill the Jones. And we could reduce the attack to 1, but it's not worth it. So we will just play another Sylvan Recruit. Another ghoul, which is bad. There is part one of the combo. Still missing two more cards. And of course Alexstrasza. We are killing the Elise. Playing Ragnar's Lightlord to get back to 29. And playing another Sylvan Recruit. The interesting part of the deck is that he will of course think that we are playing Anzu's Paladin. We don't have a chance to see that we are playing Leeroy and the Faceless. So if he has brawls, he might just save them for later. Ooh, that's a Ragnaros. I'd like to make him now 3-3 and play the Wild Pyromancer and the Consecration. The equality isn't worth it with just one minion. None may steal our secrets. You like to play with There's a Faceless, so we are now at 18 damage. Reporting for duty. That means if we draw another Blessing of the Might, we are at 24 damage. So if we draw Alexstrasza like this, we can reduce his health. We'll lose 9 life. And he's now down to 19. So if we draw the second Blessing of Might, we will win. If we can reduce his costs, of course. Might be playing Brawl now. I wonder. I must choose. Holy Revenge, so we have another Execute at hand. Or Gore Hole. How much is it then? He is at 11. And this are 4, 6, that's enough. We we don't need to combo here. Of course, we just can just copy him. So it doesn't really matter. And he's going down. And the second game, this time versus a warlock. I will fight with honor. Keeping the Doomsayer equality and two silver here. Hopefully we will draw another wild pyromancer. Because he's most likely playing Zulok. There it is, White Walker. Let's coin right into the Swamp Ooze. Dark Peddler. So we can't buff the Void Walker. And there's a Wild Pyromancer, so that game should be pretty good for us. We can clear the board when he's floating it. And then he will run out of steam eventually. As a Zulok, he's of course using his hero power quite often, so he will lose life a lot, and we can combo earlier, also playing the Flame Imp. Still waiting for the Doomsayer. Three minions are not enough for me to play Wild Pyromancer and Equality now. We will wait and play the two silver champion to kill the Flame Imp. I'd like to lure him into playing more minions. There's the Direwolf. And come on, one more. Only the hero power. There's another one. So now we will play the Wild Pyromancer and Equality. Another two silver champion, great. And we will clear the minion. Imp Gang boss, great target for the two silver champion. For justice. We are also dropping the Doomsayer, so he can't play much next turn. The end is coming. Job done. Life tapping again, bringing him down to 21. So in fact we don't need that much of a combo later. There's Alexstrasza that might help us as a player to regain 15. Playing the Acolyte and the Sylvan Recruit. No need to play the Wild Pyromancer. And we also won't attack the face here. Ooh, and Ragnaros, that's interesting. In the Zulok deck, he's hitting the Acolyte of Pain, giving us Lay on Hands and Equality. I'm thinking about playing Lay on Hands here first. He might hit us to the face. But we can clear his board when he's playing more minions next turn. So we will draw 3 extra cards. And of course, if he's hitting the Silver and Recruit, we won't lose any life. This is Spawn of Enzeus. Dark Peddler. And most likely one or two other minions. He has 4 mana left. Playing a Defender of Argus, so hopefully the Ragnaros is hitting the minion. No, the face. So we are now playing the Wild Pyromancer and Equality. And also dropping the Doomsayer plus the Sylvan Recruit, so we again can't play a minion. The turn after that we can play the Emperor or also the Ragnaros to regain life. It depends on what we are drawing. He is now down to 18. We are drawing the Libra, for example. The Emperor is a card to play. With the Acolyte, I will still play the Emperor. So we now can play the combo. If we draw Leroy, we can reduce his health depending on if he's playing another life tap. Using another life tap, so he's now down to 16. And playing 2 knife jugglers. That's interesting. We can kill the Void Walker, attack for 6, then he's down to 10. And then we can play the Ragnaros to get back to 24. Yeah, that's good, I think. For justice. Also, we are reducing, of course, more cards. He is pretty much forced to clear the board here. He otherwise would get too much damage. He's now down to 8. So we just need Leroy to finish him. If we drop the Tyrion, we of course getting a weapon when he dies, so that will be 5 damage as well. Playing the Councilman, he most likely has the tentacles at hand. But we can just play the Aldor Peacekeeper onto the Councilman. Soulfire, and he's dropping the Forbidden Ritual, great. And the Sea Giant won't help him. And so he has lost.
Put your faith in the light.
So, giving up. Second game, easy win. Kaboom! What a great deck! If you have enjoyed the video for today, don't forget to subscribe and watch out for more content on my channel. You can also follow me on Twitch and Twitter, as well as supporting me on patreon.com. Thanks for watching this episode, and see you soon until my next video. Bye guys!